¿Qué tal, chicos? Bueno, ahorita nada más van a estar los que estén interesados en tomar clase, ¿eh? No quiero a todos. Yo de hecho pensé que no iba a tener alumnos, pero bueno. Me parece muy bien que estén interesados e interesadas o traten de hacer el intento. Ok, vamos a empezar primero con una parte de vocabulario. Entonces, para esto necesito que tomen notas los que vayan a estar conmigo en la sesión. Tener ahí a la mano su cuaderno. Tiene que ser a mano para que vayamos aprendiendo a escribir también y a leer en inglés. Porque su examen de writing a mí me gusta que lo hagan a mano. Si ven ahí el pizarrón, no hay ningún problema, si lo alcanzan a ver bien. Excelente.
Sí, se ve.
Bueno, en lo que voy aceptando a los demás compañeros, ponemos el título. The title for today is the next one, is Stage of Life. Stage, o más bien en plural, stages. Stages of life. Ajá. A ver, sigo admitiendo. Híjole, pensé que no iban a entrar muchos. ¡Cagajo! Bueno, ni modo, hay que desquitar la quincena. Bueno, pero ahorita los que ya tengan la cámara apagada, pues los vamos sacando, ¿no? De todas maneras, no me da tiempo de estar así como que al pendiente de todo, pero todas mis sesiones las grabo. Entonces, después reviso con detenimiento las grabaciones y si veo que pues tienes apagada la cámara, pues ya no te admito en la siguiente, ¿no? De eso no hay ningún problema. Y también, bueno,
Profesor,
dígame.
es que, bueno, estoy viendo mi cámara aquí y no sé por qué se ve naranja, o sea, no me veo.
Sí, te
Entonces
ves naranja.
puedo salirme y me vuelvo a admitir. No sé si
Claro que
el
sí.
problema. Ok,
Sí.
gracias.
Si no, entra de tu celular, a ver. Ok, bueno, ahí está. Let's start with Stages of Life. Cristian Flores, ¿qué entiende por eso? Stages of Life. What's the meaning of that? What do you understand about it?
Algo así como etapas de la vida, algo así.
Exacto, exactly. That is the idea, ¿no? Different stages of life. And starts with, well, the stages start with the first one that is birth, ¿no? This is the first one. This is the first stage, birth. And what is the stage of the humankind in this stage of life? Okay, let me check another color. This one. Okay. This, when you are babies, right? When you are a baby, when you are a baby, you are in this stage, no? When you were born from 0 to maybe 3 years old. It means that you are a baby, no? Okay. This is the first one. The next one is when you are in your childhood. When you are in your childhood. Childhood. And when you are in your childhood, in that stage of your life, is when you are a child. No? From 4 years old to 12. So. Okay, what is the next one? When the childhood finishes, the next one is the adolescence. The adolescence, is the next one, adolescence. Okay, and you are a teenager. You're a teenager in this stage. You're a teenager. What is the next? Well, most of you are in this stage, no? In the adolescence. First the birth, childhood, adolescence. Now the next one is the middle age. The middle age. Ah, I forgot the years here. Okay, Jonathan, Jesus, what do you imagine about the years? Okay. Stephanie Torres, what do you imagine about the years in this stage, in the adolescence, teenager? Around how many years? Well, the next one here in childhood is 12 years, no? So the next one is 13. What do you think? What do you think is the end of this stage? Stephanie Torres.
Is 21?
Repeat.
21.
Okay, it's a little bit less. It's less. It's 19 years. Most of the parts of the world, because here in Mexico is 18, no? When you receive your IFE, is 18, but in most of the countries is when you are 19 years old. Perfect. Okay, let's continue. Middle age. No, middle age is, well, middle age has two different periods. The first one is when you are a young adult. A young adult. And the other one is when you are a middle age adult. Young adult, middle-aged adult. Okay, what about the years? Okay, the years. Young adult, around 20. 20 to 34 years old. 20 to 34 years old. And what about middle-aged adult? Well, 35 to 64 years. What is the next? The next one is old age. When people become old. That is the old age. And you have here, now the first one, baby, child, teenager, young adult, middle-aged adult. The next one is senior citizen. Senior citizen. Sixty-five years, and more. When you are 65 years and more, well, you are a senior citizen and you are in an old age stage of your life. And finally, no? And finally, it is the death. That is the death, no? That is the last stage of the life. Perfect. Most of you students are in adolescence, no? You are in the adolescence, and in my case, I am 34 years old, so I am in, no, sorry, 34, no, 39. I am 39. Okay, Reyes Núñez, tell me, what is the stage of my life if I am 39 years old?
Middle-aged adult?
Yeah, I am middle-aged adult. Yes, and you are teenagers. Teenagers or adolescents. It's another word. Adolescents or teenagers. Perfect. That is the first part. Thank you very much, students. Let's continue with the next part. Let me share the screen. The first part of this vocabulary part, we are going to check more vocabulary about these stages from your life. Let me check. Okay, this is unit one, no? Family life is the title of this unit. And let's start with this one. Okay, Jocelyn Flores, help me with the first photograph, please. Letter A.
Maybe he is 4 to 12 years old, uh-huh. And he's a child.
Excellent. Oh, shit. Okay. The letter B is senior citizen. Ramirez Rangel, help me with the next. The years. Tell me the years.
He's 64?
Or more. Perfect. Medina Villafuerte, letter C. Victor, letter C.
Yes, he's a middle-aged adult.
Okay. Oh, well, let me see.
Oh.
Because we have another picture here. Check. Okay. What do you think, Medina? Well, it's teenager, and the years.
It's for 13 and 19.
Okay, 13, 19, perfect. Next one is for Adrián González. The woman in picture D. Man,
is young adult?
Young adult.
Yeah.
No, I suppose young adult is the letter F. What is the letter D?
Middle age adult.
Okay, middle age. adult years.
35.
264. Perfect. Daniel Garcia, the next one, letter E. ¿No, Daniel? Oh, my God.
¿Daniel García o Daniel Garita?
A ver, déjame ver qué dice aquí. Garita, tienes razón. Sorry. Daniel Garita, letter E.
It's a baby.
Years.
Three years.
Okay, zero from 3 years. Okay, thank you. Cano Perez, Donovan, the last one, letter F, the most difficult.
Young adult.
Uh-huh. Years.
1934.
Well, it's 20, no? 20 to 34. Thank you very much. This is the first part of the vocabulary. Uh-huh. Let's continue with the next part. The next part from the exercise number 2 is about put the stages of life in order, okay? Nieto Ortega, Sergio, tell me the correct order, please. Faster, faster, faster.
¿La traducción o cómo?
Oh, my God. Thank you. Ventura Morales, José, please.
Yes. Beer.
Oh. Aline, Yasmin, please. What is the correct order?
The first one was bird.
Uh-huh.
The second one... childhood.
Uh-huh.
The third one, adolescence.
Uh-huh.
Next, middle age.
Okay.
Next is old age.
And finally?
The last one was death.
Exactly. That is the correct order. Thank you very much. Next one. The next one, the first part is for Hernandez Masas. You have 3 categories here. You have male, female, a male, or female, no? And in, on the top, in the red rectangle, you have different words for family relationships, family members, no? You have nephew, niece, grandson, uncle, wife, stepfather, grandfather, aunt, cousin, brother-in-law. In first semester, you check some others, no? You check the sister, daughter, etc., no? So in this exercise, you have to tell me what words, which words are for male, which ones are for female, and which others are for male or female? Well, I meant both. Okay, Hernandez Masas, tell me, nephew, is male, female, or male, or male, or female?
Male.
Nephew, perfect. Okay, Iván Carrizales, niece.
Niece is male or feminine? Feminine?
For both?
¿Eo?
No, ese no se puede usar para ambos. Bueno, ¿qué es eso, Iván? Todas esas palabras las vieron en primer semestre.
Ay, qué anís, si mal no recuerdo.
Bueno, es sobrina. ¿En dónde va?
¿Mandé?
Sobrina. ¿Dónde va?
¿En femenil?
Female. Ok, perfect. Rodrigo Zamora, grandson.
Male of fame.
No. ¿Te acuerdas qué significa, Rodrigo? What's the meaning of grandson?
Como hijo mayor, algo así.
Es nieto. ¿En dónde va? Nieto.
En femo.
¿En femenino? No.
No, en male.
Ah, okay, perfect. Male. Okay. Oh, ya me adelanté. Bueno, uncle. Yesenia, ¿qué significa uncle? What's the meaning of uncle? Es masculino, male. ¿Qué significa? Yesenia Pérez.
¿Tío?
Exacto. Siguiente, wife. Ingrid, male, female, or both? Ingrid, Adriana Ortega.
Is female.
Is female, yeah. What's the meaning of this, Ingrid? Híjole, le atinaste. Es esposa.
¿Tía?
Esposa. Ok, Andrés. Stepfather.
En mail. En mail.
What is the meaning?
Padrastro.
Exactly. Fabián. Grandfather.
En mail.
¿Qué significa? What's the meaning?
Abuela.
Perfect. Joana Vázquez. Aunt.
Female.
What's the meaning?
Yeah.
Perfect. Ahumada Montaña. Montaño, perdón, sorry. Ahumada Montaño Cousin.
Male.
Male. What's the meaning?
Sobrino.
Sobrino, ok. Puede ser tanto masculino como femenino. Puede ser primo o prima. Entonces ese sería en la última columna, que es male or female. Para ambos, both, for both, cousin. Ok. Y la última es para Valeria Telles, brother in law.
En male.
¿Qué significa? What's the meaning?
Cuñado.
Cuñado, excelente. Bueno, son algunas palabras, aparte de las que ya habían visto en primer semestre cuando vieron el árbol familiar, ¿no? Family tree. Sí, nada más estamos recordando. Y así es el inglés. Vemos cosas que ya vieron en los niveles pasados y empezamos a ver cosas nuevas para seguir con avanzando con los niveles, ¿no? Ok, bueno. Seguimos con algo un poquito más interesante. A little bit interesting for the class. And is this one. Exercise 5. But it says, match the words with the descriptions. For example, husband. What is husband? Well, husband is the man that a woman is married to. That is a husband. Okay, Jocelyn, stepfather, what is the definition? The brother of your husband or wife, your mother's new husband in a second or late marriage, a daughter of your brother or sister.
The second that you said.
The second one?
Yes.
Okay, can you read?
Your mother's new husband in a second or later marriage.
Perfect. Jesús Trejo, niece. No te escuchamos, Jesús.
¿Me escuchan? ¿Me escuchan?
Ahora sí, a ver.
El segundo, tercero. The five.
Number five, the brother of one of your parents.
No. El sixth, sorry.
The sixth, the son of one of your children.
No.
Dale, 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 no pierdas el tino. Ok, ya él Serrano. Miss.
Me confundí.
Miss es
Los demás vayan pensando.
La número 6.
Híjole.
Bueno, la penúltima.
Ya le había dicho tu compañero y no era. Ok. Is the number 3. A daughter of your brother or sister. Es la hija de tu hermano o tu hermana. Es tu sobrina. Ok. Donovan Cano. Uncle.
The brother of one of your parents.
A ver, vamos a ver. Excellent. The brother of one of your parents. Thank you very much. Luis Enrique, brother-in-law.
The brother of your husband or wife.
The brother of your husband or wife. Excellent. Y la más difícil, almost impossible, es para Pepe Luis López, José Luis López. Grandson.
The son of one of your children.
Perfect. Muy bien. Excelente. Anotamos en el cuaderno. Take notes on your notebook. Number one. Ready? Your mother's, con posesivo S, your mother's son is your, y la contestamos, por favor. Number one, your mother's son is your. No me digan todavía la respuesta. Okay, repeat. Your mother's possessives, your mother's son is your. Number two, your father's wife is your. Your father's wife is your. Number three. The daughter of your parents is your. The daughter of your parents is your. Number four. The sister of one of your parents is your. The sister of one of your parents is your. Finally, the number five, the mother of your husband or wife is your. The mother of your husband or wife is your. Excellent. Nieto, a ver si ahora sí está poniendo atención. La primera. Léela toda completa y dime la respuesta.
Your mother's son is your brother.
Ajá, o puede ser tú, ¿no?
Ah, pues sí.
Brother. Or me, ¿no? Puede ser que sea yo, ¿no? Thank you, Nieto. Ok, Yael Serrano, number two. Ay, otra vez, sí, otra vez. Again.
Your father's wife is your mother.
Excellent. Next one is for Jocelyn Flores.
Yeah. The daughter of your parents is your sister.
Perfect. Next one. Tello Sanchez, number four.
The sister of your parents is your uncle.
Uncle. Pero si te acuerdas en la tablita de ese rato, uncle es masculino.
Sí. Aunt. Sí.
Aunt. Méndez Romero, number five. Méndez Romero. Calling to Meléndez, Méndez Romero.
Voy, aguanten. Me estoy analizando. Dice, la madre de tu esposo es tu... La madre de tu esposo...
O esposa.
Aguante. Es que yo nunca soy bueno en eso. La madre de tu esposo...
La madre del esposo
es tú.
¿Qué viene siendo? Imagínate que estás casado y la mamá de tu esposa, ¿qué viene siendo de ti?
Mi suegra.
Así es. ¿Y cómo se dice suegra? ¿Te acuerdas? Si no te acuerdas, dime.
Adelante, lo ando buscando.
Se dice Monster in Law.
Monster in Law.
Se dice Mother in Law.
Eso.
Mother in Law. Así se dice, Mother in Law. Ok. Perfect. Entonces, el día de hoy checamos vocabulario de... Stages of Life, checamos algunos de Family Relationships. Entonces, la actividad del Classroom es que me suban su apunte. Y eso sería todo, como el meme de ¿se acabó la clase? Así yo igual. ¡Goodbye!